In this video, we will discuss about the sparse matrix. In a matrix, if there are m rows and n columns, then the space required to store the numbers will be m into n into s, where s is the number of bytes required to store the value. Suppose there are 10 rows and 10 columns and we have to store the integer value, then the space complexity will be bytes, which is given by 10 into 10 into 2, which is equal to 200 bytes. Here 2 bytes are required to store an integer value. It is observed that many times we deal with the matrix of size m by n, and value of m by n are reasonably higher and only a few elements are non-zero. Such matrices are called sparse matrix, where sparse matrix is defined as it is a matrix containing few non-zero elements. For example, if matrix is of 100 by 100 and only 100 elements are non-zero, then for accessing these 10 elements are non-zero, then for accessing these 10 elements, one has to make 1000 times scan. Also, only 10 space will be with non-zero elements, remaining space of the matrix will be filled with zeros only. That is, we have to allocate the memory size 100 by 100 into 2, which is nothing but the 20,000 bytes. Hence, sparse matrix representation is a kind of representation in which only non-zero elements along with their rows and columns are stored. Here, this is the example of dense matrix, which is matrix with elements like 1, 2 up to 9. And this another example, which is nothing but the sparse matrix, where only 2 elements are non-zero and remaining elements are 0. Sparse matrix, it is represented with triplet only. That means it stores rows, columns and values. Rows, columns and values. The zeroth rows will be store total rows of the matrix, total columns of the matrix and total non-zero values. For example, as shown here, 6 by 7 and number of non-zero terms are only 8. In our space matrix, representation will be shown as in this table, where index 0 to 8, these are the indices, and only these elements are shown which are non-zero. So at 0th index, we will store rows number, column number and 8. So here we will store 8th element by using this sparse matrix. Now here, this sparse matrix can be implemented by using Python programming. Can be implemented by using Python programming, where this sparse matrix consists of only zeros and only non-zero elements. We can perform operation on these matrix or this sparse matrix, like the transpose of sparse matrix. Then during this transpose of matrix, interchange rows and columns, also maintain the rows in a sorted order. Here, this transpose of a matrix, it can be performed on the sparse matrix. Now here, time complexity of a transpose matrix is fast. Here, this program is, in case this sparse matrix transpose is faster than transpose of a dense matrix. Here, if you consider the time and space trade-off, time space trade-off is basically situation where either space efficiency, that is memory utilization, can be achieved at the cost of time, or the time efficiency, that is performance efficiency, which is called as a time and space trade-off. Means what? If time is decreased, it will increase space, and if space is decreased, it will increase time. For example, let us consider a program like compilers in which symbol table is used to handle the variables and constant. Now if entire symbol table is stored in the program, then the time required for searching and sorting the variable in the symbol table will be reduced, but memory requirement will be more. On the other hand, if we do not store the symbol table in the program and simply compute the table entries, then memory will be reduced, but processing time will be more. So in this case, if you increase the time, it will decrease space. If you decrease the time, it will increase the space. This is such a trade-off. Such a concept is called as a time-space trade-off. Okay, thank you.